Hi, everybody. Welcome to A Quickie with Miss B. Welcome back for another week. Today is your mundane Monday. Thanks so much for joining us. All this week, we're going to be talking about the funny things that people say.
If you hear any barking, the grand dog's over, so.
Yes. He thinks he has to guard Granny's house. It's like, I'm on guard duty while I'm here. Okay, so today's Monday, and we're going to talk about dearly departed, which means we're going to talk about people and the funny things that they say at funerals.
I'm looking forward to it. Here lies Frankie. Yeah, Frankie Five Fingers. I always love that name, Frankie Five Fingers. Why do they call him Five Fingers? He's got five fingers.
Five finger discount?
No.
Oh, I thought it was because he stole stuff.
No. That's Frankie Five Fingers. Why do they call him Five Fingers? Because he's got five fingers.
That's it?
That's it.
Really?
Jeez. I love that one. Oh, yeah, that's Frankie Five Fingers. Really? Why do they call him Five Fingers? Because he's got five fingers.
Oh, okay. All right. So here you go. Let's talk about some of these funny things that people have said. This person actually said, I hate going to funerals because I'm not a mourning person.
Wow. So, but if you're going to have an attitude somewhere, that's a great place to have an attitude. They'll be like, what's the matter with him? Why is he so down? We're at a funeral. So pretty much everybody at a funeral has an attitude. They're either bawling or going, I can't believe it's good. So, I mean, that's actually a good place to be in the morning if you've got an attitude. Bad place to be drunk, though.
Well, I would think that if you're having it in the afternoon or the evening, you know, or early evening, because, you know, some people do, and you say that, that would really throw people off.
Yeah.
Be like, what the?
You're going to come to the funeral? I'm not a morning person. Well, this is his last morning before we put him in the ground. You don't suppose you could, like, I don't know, chip it up one more time for old Bobby, do you?
This one. Somebody said, you know what they always say? You can't spell funeral without fun.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
What is wrong with you?
Let's play spin the bottle at the funeral. Yeah. He was a pervert anyway, so let's do that. Yeah. I wonder what they do at a pervert's funeral.
I don't know.
Speed dating? Ding. Hi, how you doing? My name's Tommy. I like long walks in the on the beach, and I'm an Aries. Yeah. What do you do? Speed dating at a pervert's funeral, or you show movies? Debbie does all of Dallas again.
What kind of fun, quote unquote, are you having at the funeral?
Tommy Two Tone and a long ride home. I mean, really?
Yeah, this is kind of funny, too. Somebody said, this is a quote, amazing tradition. They throw a great party for you on the one day that you know you can't come.
Yeah.
It's not like you could go up to him and say, oh, great party.
Now, you know what I would probably end up doing, though? I would lock the doors and have them start the funeral with nobody there. And then I would go to there and open the doors. Goes, God, everybody, you're all late to his funeral? He said that all along, that everyone's going to be late to my funeral. I can't believe it. Come on, they've already started to get in here, people. Gosh, gosh, poor guy. Gosh. Make them all late. Make him feel about this big. Like, oh, you guys are all late to his funeral. Man.
I can't imagine.
Yeah. Put a sign on there that says use back door. Everyone goes to the back door. Everyone's late. You take the sign off, open the doors. Everyone's like, what? What? You're like, God, people, come on. Shh. Keep it down. Come on. Get in here. You're all late. You're all late. God, you were all late to his funeral. I can't believe it.
Oh, I can't. I can't even imagine. I don't know. I can't imagine somebody saying that, though. I mean, I hate funerals because I'm not a mourning person. Putting that in the, you, when you're speaking about.
Yeah. I'm sorry we're having the funeral at 10 this evening. I know it seems a little late, but Billy wasn't a mourning person, so.
And what kind of fun are you going to have? Oh, I know. You should pass out, you know, like those little bottles that you get on the airplane so yeah. Everybody nips. Can do a shot.
Give everybody a nip. Yeah. Grandma's sitting there bawling her eyes out. Here you go. No. Open up. Open up. There you go. All the way down. There you go. What was that? Straight grain alcohol. You're going to be fine in about 4 minutes.
I feel good. And on that note, we need to take a break. We'll be back in a moment. Welcome back, everybody. You're listening to A Quickie with Miss B. If you missed the first half of the episode, please go back and check that out. And as always, thanks so much for joining us.
What was that? What? Rented lips. What in the world?
Oh, my brain and my mouth are not cooperating today.
Yeah, I've heard you try to make excuses twice. You did real good. You were like, well, it's just, like, what does that mean? Is that like you gave up or what? I was going to tell you a total BS thing, but I don't have the strength.
It's kind of like when you hit the, when you're playing the record and it just gets stuck in that one groove.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That's where I was at.
Yeah. She's like, well, I'm done, but I'm not done. So there's that.
Uh-huh.
I'm done, but I'm not finished.
Something smells like macaroni and cheese in my house and there's nobody here cooking.
All right. Well, okay. That's a special moment. What's for dinner? Mac and cheese? Sure, why not? Talk to Casper. He's doling it out.
It does.
Eric's downstairs like making macaroni. She's going, she's going to go crazy. Watch.
Yeah, that's probably
he's got a little burner down there making upstairs. You're like, I'm smelling mac and cheese. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm drinking beer. Like, wow, that's great. I smell mac and cheese.
I do. Smells like the pasta noodles cooking.
Boy, that's a pretty weak smell, pasta noodles cooking. It's like boiling water and salt. Yeah, making macaroni and cheese, huh? No, I was making pasta. Plain noodles. Smells like mac and cheese to me, or at least the beginning.
Casper told me it was going to be mac and cheese. Yeah.
You sure? Come on.
Oh, excuse
went
me.
Out, went out to start the car today.
Mm-hmm. Nothing.
I'm like, are you kidding me? That thing is frozen solid.
Yeah.
We hit 40 below overnight.
You got the weather that we had the other day.
Yeah, so it's going to be like, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Battery's all charged up and it's like going, yeah.
Nice I don't try. Think so. Yeah.
Everything's shrunken so tight. It's an 8-cylinder, 8-foot bed suffering from shrinkage. It's like I was in the pool.
Yeah, it was super cold yesterday.
Yeah, you can't do anything right now. Yeah, it's mm-mm. just totally, it's just frozen solid.
Oh.
The snow, yeah. The 4 feet of snow, it's all out there, is now the snow is so cold, the snow has turned to ice.
Mm-hmm. Yep, we get that layer.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, we wow, had that. You can walk on top of the snow. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like, holy freaking moly, that is
it's
cold.
Weird. It's very cold, very weird.
But yeah, the deck boards, I got two deck boards that are off now. They're off. Mm. They literally, it flew off. So much pressure, The nails got so constricted that they let go. Mm-hmm. And the board's off now. It's just come off.
Wow.
It's so cold. 40 below and the nails popped.
Yep. It's bad.
Yes, it is chilly.
Glad we don't have that today.
I'm glad it's not snowing today. I'm having to trade it for sub-zero, but okay.
Yeah, it's one or the other. Yuck. Okay. Here's the next one. Good funeral directors can maintain their calm through almost anything, but when some bro walks into the funeral with earbuds blaring, I immediately start my breathing meditation. Can you imagine? Somebody walking in, jamming to, oh gosh. What if this song was like AC/DC's Highway to Hell and he's jamming to that and everybody can hear it as he comes through the doors.
Baby Got Back.
Yeah.
You're sitting there just smiling, going, wiping your tear. Mm. Yeah, and they go, we can hear you. Oh, yeah, Baby Got Back. We heard. Yes, yeah. You mind turning that off? Yeah, thanks.
I wonder how many people have actually done that. Come to a funeral with their earbuds just blaring whatever music that they're playing.
I did see somebody at a funeral once that was going, we're at the service right now. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you're like
on the phone talking about
they love speaker though. They do speaker.
Well,
what you doing? Well, we're over at the service. Oh wow, who died? Tommy died. Yeah, you're like, wow. Was he old? Yeah, he died of old age. Oh wow, that sucks. Had a lot of people there. Yeah, you're like going, Dude, turn off the speakerphone. Wow, you disrespectful. You disrespectful cuss. Wow.
That's crazy. I can't even imagine. Here's the last one I'll leave you with for today. This is a quote. Death is too negative for me. I will be popping off for a long cup of tea. Do splash out two bags into the pot. And for my God's sake, keep the water hot.
Wow. Okay.
Somebody that's started off their eulogy like that. And that's the end of our dearly departed episode for today, boys and girls. Come back and join us again tomorrow.